Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Yes, and because it's a Thursday, we have to throw back. So, on my way to work today, I first watched different clips from different countries, all trying to tell people, stay home, you can come visit us another time, just don't come now. And they did one for Uganda. Did you see it? It was dope. That was the tourism board. Yeah, they did one for Uganda, and then it kind of hit me, because I know most of you millennials don't know jack. When you talk about things like UEB, UTC, when a beer was at 1-2, do you know Bell beer was at 1-2? 800. Then even 800. A soda was how much? Bisatu. Y'all didn't know this ish, but walking through the streets of Kampala at this particular time kind of reminds me of way back then, when life was simpler, when it was not a competition, when you having a car and me walking wasn't a big deal. But lately, they find you walking. Oh, by the way, still on this same throwback. I have to throw back to all of you who own cars and were telling us, a tiny motor car. What's up? What's good? Are you using that? Are you using that? Are you? So yeah, I want to throw back to the old nostalgic times when life was simpler, when we had less to complicate our lives. And I want to throw back to Mother Nature. If you people haven't noticed one thing, this COVID-19 has actually helped clear out our ozone. Like when you see aerial views of the world, we're cleaning up. So yeah, we're throwing back to the good old days when life wasn't, it wasn't so many things. We didn't have shady politicians, did we? I know those ones are timeless. Oh, they had shame then, eh? No, they don't. Okay. Anyway, that's it. My name is Tina Fierce One. The name of the show, you know, it needs no introduction, but I just might. The show is Scoop and Scoop, and it's proudly sponsored by Coca-Cola. About to wear video molecule COVID. Yeah. Of the show by wishing Joseph Mayanja, aka Chameleon, aka Atageja Atakoga, aka Toleta Minzani, happy birthday to you, Jose Chameleon. And we do hope that with this newfound edge, you will have newfound wisdom and make better choices when it comes to your political affairs and pretty much your musical affairs. You're gonna be one of you. Plus taxes. Oh, yeah. Yeah, oh, Camille, let this new edge be the edge where you learn how to pay taxes. Abi, we are begging, you know? We are begging. Hi, Tobayo, I wish that one a happy birthday. That's from me and the entire Scoop on Scoop team. Another person I wanted to holler at. You people know I don't like Denzel. Yes, I'd say it out openly. So Denzel, who happens to work with us, that guy who went to Big Brother and lost so terribly. Quarantine in every corona, be mutuala. He sat down. And he did a song. The title of the song is Honey and Lonely. I listened to the song, people. And I caught myself asking myself that very question. No, me asked myself. I doesn't know what to do. But me was asking myself, and we were wondering why we thought and had so much hope that Denzel would do a song and it would be a banger. Like, I'm so disappointed in myself. Very, so very much disappointed. The title of the song is Honey and Lonely. Come on. Imagine that title of a song coming from a guy who told us his best friend is a cat. That makes him a pussycat. That's Honey and Lonely. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Anyway, please, I was just taking the time out to tell you, please don't listen to it. Those are minutes of your time you'll never get back. Ever. Yeah, done with that. PSA. Ha! These corona times, yo, we should like find like a nice hashtag for these times. What should we call them? The COVID times? Hashtag when we were all useless. Hashtag when nothing meant anything anymore. Anyway. yes. Today morning, I wake up. You know how my president has made it a point to let us know who has basically given to COVID relief and, you know, in the fight towards COVID, the pandemic. And I got up to Airtel, and Airtel, your trusted telecommunications network gave us $1.250 billion. I was like, God damn, they have got to be the biggest donors. Biggest. My president gave us 1.3 bu of his salary. Mr. President, gasina dakoba banaba airtel. 1.3. Is it to buy testing kits? My president, couldn't you give us that 1.3 and go to Rachitura and give us like about 60 herds of cattle? Couldn't you? Couldn't you go to your torch and get over to Shabri, your uncle torch and come nana, ningi, kumininga, tan, who cares? Bakatugagra. 1.3? What? Anyway, that is what my president gave. I have not given, so he gave. Hey! So, back to them. They have given out 1.250 billion shillings. I was like, oh, say what? And that's not just it. They have other things that come with that 1.250 bill. I was like, excited. Then the idiot in me, who can't help who I am, decided to get a pen and paper and a calculator because my nut don't work that well. I need a calculator. I'm like, so 1.250 billion has been given into COVID relief. If I could calculate how much data every Ugandan who has a smartphone since this lockdown has used, ooh child, it's a lot more than 1.250 billion, don't you think? So this is money that they just said, we have some pocket change, but we're still grateful for it. Don't get me wrong. We are grateful for it, but I'm wondering, all these companies that are giving out all these things, nebali about gorillas, next thing you're going to hear is that someone has bought Pampers. Pampers. Yeah, diapers. They're a serious thing, by the way. Kids need diapers. But let me ask, all this money is coming in. We are grateful. At the moment, confirmed COVID cases in my country are 82. Out of those 82, 40-something are healed. 18 or 19 are in stable condition and on their way to a speedy recovery. In it, don't you feel like we're doing too much? No, it's okay until you get scared about it like this. Certain countries started out with very low numbers, kept it on a good margin, and then it burst out. So what if all these guys are giving all this money now and we're putting it to good use, and then like something terrible happens again and we have another breakout? What are we going to do? The money will be there. Abigail, are you sure the money will be there? Are you sure the money is there right now? But I have eaten it. Do you return? Yo, I'm just saying, I think we need more practical relief. We need practical. As a muntu wa wansi, this is what I'm going to tell you. If I was Airtel and I was the CEO at Airtel, this is what I was going to do, because this is what I know muntu wa wansi chayagala. On just their network alone, we are how many Ugandans? 40 something? 46? 40 million Ugandans, innit? Out of the 40 million Ugandans, I would like to believe that Airtel has the biggest chunk. Two networks, Airtel, MTN, they have it half and half. If you got that 1.250 billion and returned it to us in form of Airtel money, because we are all registered. If you own the network, you are registered. I feel like as a service provider and a person who pays for your services, I would feel wanted, needed, appreciated, valued, and most importantly, thought of and cared for if you just sent a kata take my way. A couple light, a small, 30 grand. Can we do the mathematics, people? 1.250 billion. Divided by give or take, they could have like about 20 million Ugandans on their network. How much is that? Kusigala kone balance. A couple like 30k. Okay, you can even be kusigala balance. You can get that balance the following week. And you still give it to us because we're still going to be buying data. Or you just throw it on my phone and I still give it back to you because I'll be using it for data. Like, why don't these people think? If I was a marketing manager at Airtel right now, I would give it back to you in Airtel money because I know you're definitely going to give it back to me through data, through phone calls. What else do you have to do, people? You're home. Those are the only things you're using. Think, people. But the conversation started by us saying, thank you, Airtel. Don't confuse Ugandans. You cannot begin telling Ugandans not to give. For him, he wants them to give us stuff, not cash. How shall we prosper as a nation if they're just giving us stuff? Okay, now you're too bougie. Gil is saying Airtel should give everybody a smartphone. Like, what? But it makes sense. Because fact of the matter is, whether we want to kuchikiriza or not, the amount of corruption that is happening right now are B. Wetinde says, someone called me from those same stores. We have spies everywhere. Nangamba tina. Temuloza mbubuli chebaswa mie kumpeo chemulida. Akaunga Tony Bidi. Zitu ukao. Does it work out? What was the name registration? What was it about? Ngabazi Gabi Dairy. Now you're giving cash. Is it on a bank account? Airtel, clarify, because we're trying to be upright citizens here. We are doing the maths. We are doing all the maths for everybody who gives money. Wait. Let me first put the Airtel story back. Did y'all see that story yesterday? So Buganda Kingdom came out and gave something like 100 million to COVID relief, yo. I was like, feel you. So did the Basoga. Came out and gave us money. I'm like, y'all don't even know. You got us. Then a press release letter comes out. I don't even know how true that is. Where Buganda Kingdom, actually the radio stations, I think, and the employees, you know, because they have that part where they work. There's a letter that's going around and they're saying, we will not be able to pay you your money in full. Some of you will get 70%, some of you will get 50%, some of you will get 20% for the month of April. So they're not talking about all the past months that these guys haven't been eating or working. I'm like, you got 100 million and gave it to the nation. Good stuff. But then you forgot your people, who you see on a daily. Who you no need to eat? Who need your support as an employer during these tough times? The hypocrisy. Abaganda bagendo situ kabayombe nzembiogera. Before you give that 100 million to the government to help fight COVID, you should have first figured out if your people's is paid. Should have first figured out if your people's who work for you, who help with everything that you earn. Actually, those same people are the ones who worked for that 100 million that y'all gave away, and now they don't have salaries. Jesus, preach! Hey, yes. Anyway, COVID relief money, do y'all think that, like, if this ish blows out, do you think there'll be, like, accountability? We're not going to trust Kadaga anymore. I'm sorry, for shame, Kadaga. I can't deal with Kadaga at the moment. And what is wrong with my president throwing people under the bus? Aish! Kadaga was up there like, leave the money. They can get it. Court order. Shut up. We're getting the money. We're going to make it work. And my president came on TV and he's like, I advised her not to do it and she did it. Return the money. I'm like, imagine if my president, Mr. Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, was on a reality TV show with ratchet bougie girls. He would be the snake. He'll be the chick who's like, oh, by the way, not just to tell you, but she said your breath stinks. And then she's like, he can throw you under any bus, eh? Actually, Kadaga tibamsude under a bus. They threw her under a very fast moving metro train. Yeah, because wait. The NRM bus. I swear, I think they throw under the NRM bus because damn, son. But you know what? These things, they got bitandisa kunyumira. The politics is standing out. Different leaders are also saying things and doing things, and we are seeing things. Dare I say it? How about we stretch this for another 3 weeks? I'm just saying. Yeah, before you beat me up and tell me that we not chakulia, I'm an essential worker. Twali tugenda ngo kola ku TV wano. Nga mtu gambe chitwa twala ku TV we are talent. Tetwasoma. Hello, accountant. Hello, engineer. Hello, lawyer. Yeah, my name is Tina. I'm a TV personality and I'm considered an essential worker in 2020.
Ain't that beautiful?
Tuachali awo. I like to use this color. Kansa nyula nye. Bigambo vya Luganda. Ngero zo Luganda mmanyi ntono. Tupatu gola mnyera. Jawe vikere. So, I saw a photo of Nimrod and some other guys. I know you guys have seen that ish. And they were arrested. Now here's what happens. Bebe cool. Ebi okuli abia fe. Ne sente ze nali impo gani dako wano. Simanyomba yaba mwa sente. Na ye mmeri. So different people reached out to Nimrod to help distribute food to, I think, DJs and artists and something like that. It was one of them. Mm-hmm. Now, I kept telling you people, some people are so worthless until you see it happen and unfold in front of your eyes. I think the last time I did a DJ Nimrod story was like about 3 years ago because I was done with his bull. I was. Anyway, when they gave him this COVID relief, instead of this lumpen, doing what he's supposed to do in regards to respecting social distancing, in regards to, you know, 1.5 meters away, in regards to wash your hands, anybody could be sick. No, not this fat idiot. Nah, yeah, Keto is laughing at a teapot. Suck on that. He went and told the entire neighborhood, you know, mere mujichime, the neighborhoods are hungry. In case you didn't know, everybody's waiting for food, so they stood up to go get food. Before you know it, you have a mammoth crowd over at his house. Ko police la bendingi dieno. Nebajisuna. Nebajituwala. To police. And then different blogs were saying so many things about it. I personally am going to just tell you this. Mana mtu je ko busiru. Eh? Amageza amatono gakoya bigere. Katoni amagezi gama tonoga kwa yezebi, gere, he ended up at a police station. Couldn't you sit calmly and have a plan? The president said, if you want to give food out, there are guidelines. This idiot is the same one doing what Zake did. Zake baamu gamba, don't. He did. Nebamu savula, nemudamu kutusi nikida amanyo. Free Zake kwa afuka ndingidi ya state mbubwa wate wa inangwa kubaba na kubagwe. Banji! Banji watusomolo kuba Zake, banji. Nene Nimrod, yabadea sana migonga tebanda musiba. Because that is what my president pretty much said is attempted murder. That's attempted murder. You're finna get people sick. Your ass should be in jail forever. Forever. And the world, I think, would be a much better place without him. But with him. Not that I want him dead, no. Without him, but with him. Yeah, it would be a much better place. As everybody was throwing about their different things, and as I just, on the only thing about this story that caught my attention was, Nimrod, are you a size 4?
Y'all see that?
I swear, Nimrod's scuff foot is like this. It's like a size 2 or something. It's disrespectful. Like, if I want to get him sneakers, I have to use my 7-year-old woo child for all that body. Now you know why this man never stays with one woman. Now we know. I've been sitting here wondering, what in Nimrod akubi abantu emitwe ono mukazi ya muuba nono na muuba nono na muuba noli na muuba. Eh, sanje taterera kumbe. Auve no lumu no mugwa mumbu vize size 4 no gamba kane. Ongele. Na funo mula na sanganga is a size 2 na gamba. Thank you very much Nimrod, but kane yongereyo. No, you know, ladies. When you see a man with so many women, it doesn't mean he's got his ish together. It just means he doesn't have his ish together at all. What do you think is his response if he has a size 4? Oh, you know what? My bad. I hate being disrespectful. I'm usually nice. Nimrod. Yeah, gumaba kunyige, never know. Chimanyi, it is not easy to have luwais, but gumaba kunyige. Oh, wait, he's out on police bond, innit? I thought it's attempted murder. They still release you even for attempted murder. But what if he comes out and it's now not attempted anymore and it is murder? Proper. Of as in, I am sick, come on, y'all. No, but at the end of the day, I just need mulekerawo. Mutagere chino, all you people who want to make the news, people like Zake, mwino kumanyambute mugenda kusoya account, no kasoya, no kasoya, no kasoya, and you don't expect it to bite back. They bite back. Someone stands back and stands up and he tells you, please Ugandans, stay away from each other. If you have something to do, there are ways we can do it. And then you blatantly obsirunga bwebu kumenya, you go ahead and do what they told you not to do and expect what? Blessings? Hugs? Tap on your shoulder? Attaboy. Nah. Yeah, Nimrod was being stupid. That was the story. So Benon posted something on Facebook and he was like, so just let's just play it out. What if Eddie Kenzo is actually really suffering in Ivory Coast? What if? What if he honestly doesn't have something to eat? Because his manager claims that Eddie Kenzo is going hungry and mad and everything. What if? And he's like, what would we do as a people to help him? What people? Help with what? Who sent him? I am home waiting on my government to feed me. Ivory Coast also has a whale they are feeding. There are people who are there now. So you tell me, is that me being heartless? Because I know it for a fact that if it was, if the script was changed and it was Eddie Kenzo, this end, and just me, a regular Ugandan, stuck in Ivory Coast, I don't think he would be like, Tubayambe. Do you think he would? And I still ask the same question. Banks are doing their thing like crazy. You want to tell me, Eddie Kenzo's, it's been 2 months that your waters have run dry in 2 months. For all the travel you do, for all the concerts that are paid for in dollars you do, in a year, that in 2 months of quarantine, have all run dry. I am a regular Ugandan. My salary isn't even that great. I have 3 kids and a single man, and I'm still getting through. I'm still getting by. I'm not on the high. I'm just like every regular Ugandan right now. I can eat, I can sleep, my kids can eat. We can access a little bit of Medicare. So, Kenzo. Because if that's the truth, then I'm sorry, this sucks as balls. Everybody who is in the music industry should quit now and become a TV personality. I kid you not. If people in the music fraternity are already going broke 2 months into quarantine, you'll need to rethink your strategy about life. Think about it. Eddie Kenzo is like the most toured Ugandan artist. Eddie Kenzo does not stay in my country for longer than a month. And every time he goes out there, he's being paid in dollars. And he's not just doing one concert. This nigga goes on tour. So excuse me for being insensitive, all pun intended. Artists, quit your job. If your best, the only guy with a BET in Uganda, is crying 2 months into it, he's in another country, and not a Bulaya, a Nyonyo, call it is Bulaya, but it's Ivory Coast, TIA. We're African. We learn how to survive. We plant our food, it grows from the soil. You can walk to your neighbor and say, "Bloody rero chiganye bampeye mi mondejo." And your African brother or sister would give you. Where are all those fans of his when he was asking, "Where are you?" Wait, where are all those fans who voted for that BET and all those other things? Kids' Choice Award, Nickelodeon, where are they? I'm thinking, yo. Ugandan musicians, if your best has failed in 2 months, your strategy. You all need to start getting acquainted with the camera. Come be a TV presenter. I don't know if we'll have where to put all of you, but... Huh? 2 months? Killer, you flat out 2 months? Yo, I have freelancers, cameramen, who earn when they come to work. And because we have been in quarantine and all of this, they will probably get one story a day. I'll not lie. One story a day is not going to feed you for 3 days. But they're okay. So Kenzo, Benon, explain some ish to me. Explain it. You want to make some ish go viral for no reason. Kenzo is a grown-ass man. Let him figure it out the same way his brothers and sisters in Uganda are figuring it out. Simple. Let's move on from it. Come on. Before I can go, how many MPs have taken back the money that my president told them to take back? Someone did like a meme of like, you see, Bobby Wine was smart, he took it back. I'm like, don't be a dimwit. Any person who is vying for office and wants to look good would take that money back, because in the long run, him taking back 20 million can actually bring him back 300 billion. I'll take it back too. I'll take it back, make you fall in love with me enough to make me president, and then I'll take 300. Just say it. Tamala sibabi bagamba bino biebi bamenya bino. Ah, Lord. So none of them has taken it back. Wait, there was an MP who had got it and distributed to her people. What she then do? And that MP is still going to take back the money. We don't care what you used it for. Take it back to the public coffers. As for Litswala Rebecca Kadaga, the Honorable Right Speaker of Parliament, I think you need to change which doctors. No, this is not even about shrines. She just needs to change which doctors, because they have been advising her just the wrong way. She needs to go back to that witch doctor she was supposed to pay money to. Did she pay? Talk to that guy. He put you in Parliament. Go back to him. He'll help you stay, because the way things are going, once my president starts to throw you under buses like that and metros and trains, anyway, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's a TinaFierce1 with an H, and on Snapchat we are TinaFierce1. Catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. And by the way, tomorrow happens to be an extended version. Why? How we talked about Mbonye yesterday, I gave my 3 cents, and then we sat down and we're like, no, everyone should give their 3 cents. So tomorrow will be a continuation of yesterday's Mbonye situation. We had different people speaking on it. You are going to die. Whew. Pastors are tired. Liberals are tired. Mbonye. The thunder is still warming up. I'm out. Peace. Wash your hands. Jeez.